Shalom, brothers and sisters. Like I said, I forgot to mention a whole bunch of important facts. First of all, let me share that I didn't even explain these. We're still in Genesis chapter 8 and 9, the flood. There's a theme right here. It's expanding and contracting. That's the breathing, the spirit of Jah. This is what's going on. Now, you could a whole bunch of things play into effect, the expanding universe, the contracting universe, you know, infinitely contracting, infinitely extracting. We got the bending, we have the arc placed in the heavens as a token, the arc, the bending of space, time, and the bending of light, because after the uncovering of Noah's nakedness, they turned the other way. And so that has to do, well, this is basically the vessel. This is what I and I is to do. Bow the ship, bow down and have His Majesty direct I and I in and through Jesus. And then here's the rainbow, which represents the arc. And then this is, well, I guess, the spiraling. I forgot what that is, but it's important. Sorry. Heaven is the throne of Jah. And now, this one over here, I just did it because, I don't know, it just came to me. The Ark of the Covenant. Face to face, the angels face to face, the wings. And then, kind of like the whole circle going on. The everlasting, eternal cycle. And then, what else was it? The wings touching, I mentioned that. And well, actually our blades, our shoulder blades, and our wings, shoulder wings, our wings in fact. And then, well, the tail, the head. And also interesting, if I flip this like this, it looks like His Majesty's hands, or like this, I don't remember. There's a lot more to this, I'm sure. But anyways, I have a little bit of tape left. I'll explain the other things that I kind of missed out on. Now, it was important to note that the raven, because Arabe, in the Ethiopic, you see, they depart far away, and they, the Arab, they're traffickers, they're vagabonds, you know, and they take the place. You see, when Noah let the raven go, he sacrificed him. The raven took the place of Noah, you know, so that Noah would not put himself at risk. But Noah has dominion over them. Now this is what the Holy See and all these corrupt establishments seek to do with I and I. They seek to be to intercede. They want to cancel out Jesus Christus and they want to intercede. And so what's going on is that if we accept their intercession and become part of this corporation, or take on the name of the corporation and not the name of Shem, then we are now officially agents of their little service they provide, where they, like it was said, they know that our they want to claim to know that our nature, imagination, is evil since our youth, and so they want to play Jesus Christos and intermediates, and they want to be liable for another's death. That way, they have every right to enslave us and put us into prison or anything, because they're liable for I and I. And birth certificates play a role in this, because life is made manifest. And so what do we do with this? Well, the parents, they sign you off ignorantly so that they're going to be take the caretakers, and then they sign you off as a liability. The government, they take full responsibility for your actions, but since you're not old enough, your parents are going to be charged until you come to age. Oh, because they're taking care of your inheritance. We have an inheritance. The earth, the heavens, is the foot is the throne of Jah, and I and I, being sons of Jah, have an inheritance. But the Vatican and all of them, they trick our parents and they tell, oh, well, you know, we'll put their trust into our hands. And so what is rightfully ours is signed off to them. The thing is that I and I, as inheritors, have never came forth to reclaim, to claim what is rightfully I and I's. And so they keep quiet. They don't tell us, obviously. And they're still liable, and therefore they can tax us and do all that thing. I'll get into that later. I wasn't even supposed to get into it now. But, and so, just 1 second. And so, yeah, Ham, Shem, and Japheth, they anointed, elected a newborn government, basically, is what happened when they covered the nakedness. And they made their own little covering that appealed to man's desire, I guess. And so they turned their backs. And that's basically some of the little details that I forgot to mention. So now, that being said, let's see how much I have. 10 minutes. What can we do with that? Let's go to 1stPeter, because that's part of the Torah portion studies for this week. It's all related. 1stPeter chapter 1, verses 13 to 16, and it reads, "Wherefore gird up the loins of your mind, be sober, be sober." Like Noah, he got drunk, he slipped, caught slipping, "and hope to the end for the grace that is to be brought to you at the revelation of Jesus Christos." It's about that time, I think. "As obedient children, not fashioning yourselves according to the former lust in your ignorance, but as he which hath called you is holy, you be ye, so be ye," like so be, like the drinks, I guess, kind of. "Well, so be ye holy in all manner of conversation." Okay. Conversation. I thought of something, but okay. "Because it is written, be ye holy, for I am holy. If ye call on the Father, who without respect of persons judge it according to every man's work, pass the time of your sojourning here in fear." Okay, I was supposed to stop at 16, but Jah judges rightfully according to every man's work. So, I and I is to be holy. I and I is to be separated holy to the Lord. Not to the Holy See, the Vatican, the Holy Seat, where the Pope claims to be king of this world, and as king, an intercessor of between Jah and I, and we don't need that. We don't need your services, Mr. Pope. Well, I guess we could, the time left, we could go to 1st Corinthians, chapter 6 and verse 9 through 20, because that is also part of the reading. And it reads, "Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God?" The inheritance, that's what I and I is speaking of. "But not the unrighteous, they will not. Be not deceived." Even the very elect would be deceived. You know, I guess it all ties in perfectly. You know, give thanks to the Most High, Jah, Rastafari. neither fornicators, nor adulterers, nor adulterers, nor idol, idolaters and adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind, nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of Jah. This is what all the government systems are. They're extortioners. You know, they got guns, and so they tax you, and they don't even have a right to tax Sinai, but they tax you, and what, you know, people, well, they got the guns, you know. It's your kids shooting them to begin with. But that's what they do. They offer you a service. Hey, we won't do this if you give us that. Basically, it's they're gangsters. You know, they're no good for nothing. You know, like savages and vultures, vampires, bloodsuckers. Okay, that's enough. No, and so much. And such were some of you, but ye are washed. Ye are sanctified, but ye are justified in the name of the Lord Jesus, and by the Spirit of our God, Jah Rastafari. Now, we are justified. See, Mr. Lawyer, we could go up and say, we don't need your services. We're justified in and through Jesus Christos. Like, plain and simple, we don't need your services. You know, we don't need for you to pass judgment on I and I. And that's going to play into effect because you're not even righteous. Who are you to pass judgment? I mean, if you're wicked, that's another problem. How can we take our brothers? And this is included. Don't sue your brothers and sisters because you're going to sue them. And then this is another principle of the lesson. On how not to sue each other, because we put them into the hands of unrighteous like vampires. Now, just one second. The basic principle, and it's one of the basic principles of the use of the body. One last thing, the use of the body. I think it's not proper to say use. Obviously, we're still going to use it, but abuse, you know, abuse, they say, is wrong. But in reality, ab, father, use, you know, like to use the body for, so that the father can use the body as a tool and not just I and I use the body. That, does that make sense, I guess? You see, let me, real quick, you see. You see, this is what I was trying to explain, like ab, father, and abuse. Well, yeah, the father uses I and I, but not to just cancel out the father. Basically, separate ourselves, be holy to Jah, and let our bodies be for Jah, as a tool, as His Majesty said. And now, and so basically, tape's gonna run out, but I'll get back to this. But last little detail is that this reading right here in Corinthians, 1 Corinthians chapter 6, it's, we need to put the body, our hunger, and our sexual appetite under subjection. So I'll get back.